When I talk to you, I tell you what you have to teach the kids and how you do it. I wanted my kid to be a thinking kid, okay? I'm using old language. I wanted my kid to be creative. So I have to ask the question, what is creativity? If I don't know, I can't make my kid creative. So here's how I did it. In the beginning, he came to me when he was 4 years old. And he said, Daddy, the wheel came off my toy car. And I said, so it did. And I threw it in the garbage. And I read my book. But I'm watching him. And oh, look. Well, I said, what's the matter? He said, you threw it away. I said, I'll get you baby toys where the wheels don't come off. So he said, well, maybe I can fix it. So I reached for the toy and gave it to him. And he's sitting on the couch trying to get the wheel on. Then he gets it on. Just about a few minutes. Then I picked him up and put him in my lap. Said, that's wonderful. How did you do that? He said, I'm not that little. I said, but how did you do it? You see, the piece of iron's taken up, yeah. You see the hole in the wheels? He didn't even know what to call. I pushed on the hole and push and push and push, and it went on. I said, that's marvelous. But if you say, here, let Daddy fix it for you, let Daddy do this, let Mommy do that, you produce a big blob that does no thinking at all. So put your kids, I used to come running in the house, so my little girl said, what did you bring me? She said, I didn't bring you anything, I'm too little. Kids are always thinking, are you bringing him something? So when my little girl, when she was three, she came in the shop, and I put a wrench on a nut the wrong way. You know what that means? A wrench on a nut the wrong way? Nut, a wrench is a metal. And I put on, then I put on the wrong way again. She's watching me. It's so obvious. So she puts her little hands on it. That's no way to do it. So I says, is this all right? The wrong way again. Nothing wrong. I'll have to show you. So she put the wrench on the right way. I did that so she wouldn't look up to me. Daddy knows everything. Sometimes he doesn't know anything. So I used to come to my kids and ask them questions. I can't get this door on. What do you suggest? Well, I'm little, but I think if you put a piece of wood under the door to lift up to match the hinges, just put them in a situation. Kids of the future will be given responsibilities and they'll manage their own affairs. So one kid, when he goes into the woods, knows a lot about marine life in the stream. Another kid knows plants. Another kid knows clouds. And so each kid takes a turn of leadership. You have no permanent leader. If you rotate the leadership, it's better for the kids. Do you understand that? I don't want to be a leader. I want to give you tools to think with. Now you have to work on other people now. When they say, what if a guy doesn't want to go along with you? Just say, I don't know how to reach that guy. That's what it means. Say, you can call him names. Say, he's dumb. Or this, just say, I don't know how to reach him. So when I meet with people, if I can't reach them, I come at them another way. If that doesn't work, I try another way. Then I come back next week with a different way. When I use reason with my mother on a Japanese kid, it didn't work. Reason and logic does not change people. What changes people is your ability to reach them in their terms.